So if you're concerned about consuming excess estrogens and other endocrine disruptors, rancid carcinogenic toxins, and powerful mineral chelators that actually strip vitamins and minerals out of your body, then you definitely want to continue watching this video. You probably want to take oats out of your diet. Oats contain large amounts of excess estrogens that disrupt your hormonal balance and increase estrogenic activity in the body. They also interfere with hormonal reproductive balance, as well as contain mineral chelators that strip minerals from your body. So in today's video, I'm going to show the evidence and explore the research evidence, peer-reviewed research that's showing and backing up these exact claims. And by the end of this video, you're going to understand that you may want to take oats out of your diet if you want to live a healthy life. First off, I really think it's important to identify exactly what good health truly means, because a lot of people say this or that food is healthy, or this or that is healthy in general, but they don't really have a definition for what health is. A lot of people take their diet cults and they build their identities around those sort of things. We got to rise above that. We have to actually define on a foundational level in the body what is truly healthy. And when you try and do this, actually what you find is surprisingly simple. There's actually two things that are responsible for health in the body. The first is you need to correct all micronutrient deficiencies. Your body can't function properly if it's deficient in certain vitamins and minerals. You can't have any deficiencies, and so therefore anything that would promote a deficiency in the body is considered unhealthy. The second thing is hormonal balance. Your body needs to be in a state of hormonal balance, and what that means is actually that there's two classes of hormones in the body. There's protective hormones and stress hormones. So hormonal balance is characterized by the proper ratios between the two. So you want to make sure that your reproductive hormones, i.e. your protective hormones, and your thyroid hormone, which is protective hormones, the different types of thyroid hormones, these things have to be in a good, healthy level. In men, for example, high testosterone is a nice thing, and you see a lot of benefits from that sort of thing. But the stress hormones, on the other hand, they're ratio dependent between the protective ones. So you actually have to have low stress hormones, things like cortisol, estrogen, prolactin, SHBG. These things cannot run out of control, or else you're going to have a lot of problems with your hormonal balance. Now, if you disagree with this fundamental idea that the body is healthiest when it doesn't have deficiencies and when it's in a state of hormonal balance, then we foundationally just disagree about health, which that means that you think that the body runs properly when it is deficient in micronutrients, and you think that the body runs properly when it is out of hormonal balance, when it has low reproductive hormones and high stress hormones. If this is what you think, then good luck. I mean, nothing I can do for you on that one. But if you agree with me on the state of good health and you're watching this, then it'll naturally come together of this framework that we're operating within. And so if something goes against micronutrient deficiencies, goes against hormonal balance, technically is considered unhealthy. And this is a good way for us to develop a way of thinking that actually helps to promote our healthy habits. So in this case, though, by this definition, and I'll show you all of the evidence because there's quite a bit of it, oats are not healthy. So let's dive into the research. So right here on WestonAPrice.org, we see phytic acid content in oats. So phytic acid is actually a powerful mineral chelator, and it's very high quantities in oats. I've done another video here on the channel talking all about phytic acid. I also talk about the content of phytic acid in beans, in brown rice, things like that, that are all proven to chelate these minerals, to strip your body of these minerals and cause massive wide-scale deficiencies. So this study right here shows that because of the dense nature of the negative phosphate groups when consumed, it actually readily attaches to mineral ions, rendering them unavailable for the uptake by the body. Now this study states actually that phytate has a strong chelating property and allows for poor bioavailability in the gastrointestinal tract of multivalent metal ions, especially zinc, calcium, and iron. We see this a lot. So watch the phytic acid video. I talk about this stuff a lot, these major deficiencies. And this one, we talks about how phytic acid renders many essential minerals to be poorly bioavailable. It also talks about the mechanism and even talks about how it can bind to proteins in certain pH levels. On page 212 of this book, they state that the fact that the strong chelating effect of phytic acid has in that it shows that it forms insoluble compounds with a lot of essential minerals, including copper, cobalt, magnesium, manganese, zinc, calcium, and iron. Now, this one talks a bit about the chemistry with the calorimetric study with several minerals and their binding potential with phytic acid. This study was shown to cause an increase in excretion of minerals, nitrogen, and amino acids. This one showed that sodium phytate actually decreased the pepsin activity in digestion of protein. This study showed a dose-dependent manner of phytate causing inhibition of lipase activity. We see a lot of enzymatic interactions, like inhibition of important enzymes when consuming phytic acid. Here you see also that there's a good increase in the inhibition of pepsin as phytate intake increases as well. This one showed the inhibitory effect that phytate has on alpha amylase and proteases. And then this study showed the effect of a mixture containing phytic acid causing disruption of bacterial cell membranes, degradation of DNA, and that it caused pores in the membranes of the cells. So there was cellular damage from this. So let's look at some of the direct health effects of oats. You know, and people, and these are studies with oats that they're showing these effects. So this one showed basically that the consumption had a reduction in all male reproductive parameters, including testosterone and spermatogenesis in general. And spermatogenesis is basically the production of sperm. This one showed the lowering of cholesterol. And this one showed, again, another lowering of cholesterol. If you want to know more about why lowering your cholesterol is bad, I recommend watch my polyunsaturated fat, the vegetable oil conspiracy. Watch that video. Talk all about how the cholesterol thing is just a big myth and it's used for propaganda right now to basically poison your body. This one shows a greater postprandial increase in insulin and glucose. This one proves that oat beta-glucan does not affect satiety in humans. This one shows that statins have a testosterone-lowering effect. Here we see that beta-glucan again effectively reduces testosterone and DHT. So this one shows that zearalenone, what it is basically, and that it's an estrogen compound that's really common in oats. So zearalenone is estrogenic and immunotoxic, and that's backed up over and over again. Now this one shows the amount of zearalenone that's excreted by pigs that are fed with these oats that have it in it. And this shows the mycotoxin content of 100 organic and regular samples of oats. There are a lot of toxins in oats. Cereals that contain oats also contain a known carcinogen and mycotoxin in the U.S. Called okra toxin A. And this is also well known. I mean, I don't know why they still sell this stuff. So this one talks about mycotoxins in Europe and the effects that they have on liver, kidney, and hematopoietic toxicity, immune toxicity, reproductive toxicity, fetal toxicity, and cancer. So this one states that the mycotoxins go unrecognized by doctors until epidemics occur. Ain't that the truth? Because they're not looking for this stuff. So this one shows that the effect of mycotoxins on dogs and that it slows their metabolism down and that a common treatment for mycotoxin in food does not work. This one shows ochratoxin increasing mortality and the rate of E. coli infection in broiler chickens. This one shows zearalenone effects on female pig reproduction. These negative effects. This one shows zearalenone in urine and muscle tissue in oat-fed heifers. So a lot of livestock eats oats, obviously. This one showed 23 mycotoxins that are present in baby food, cereal, formulas, etc. This stuff's everywhere, guys. We gotta wake up to it. This one shows early development of puberty in prepubertal girls due to estrogenic activity of zearalenone. That's scary, geez. So these mycotoxins are extremely prevalent in these types of grains, especially oats. Obviously, there's a lot of different effects. This review kind of goes into the effects of mycotoxins on human health. This one is a dissertation on mycotoxins and human health, and just shows all the like terrible effects that it has on your metabolism and your hormones in general. This shows the toxic effects of zearalenone and the toxic effects it has on in vitro maturation of cells in 17 beta estradiol. This again shows more endocrine disruption of zearalenone in pigs who eat oats. This shows an oat-based diet increasing estradiol and fibrinogen levels in women. This shows increased secretion in oat diet fed to female pigs. Zearalenone also has suppressive effects on testosterone production in the Leydig cells of rats. You do not want to be suppressing your Leydig cells, that's for sure. So lambs actually consume quite a bit of oats. So in lambs that have diets of 70% oats, there's a connection between increased estrogen leading to a greater likelihood of sex differentiating toward like more female offspring, which is really interesting. What little antioxidants oats do have has actually been proven in this study to be lost in the processing and cooking. So there's no nutritional value of these oats. It's anti-nutritive. So this shows processing inactivates the antioxidants again. And in conclusion here, basically what they had is that they show that the polyunsaturated fatty acids in the oats themselves were actually oxidized and degraded before they even get to the shelves, in storage. So this shows that a range of alcohols, aldehydes, alkylobenzenes, dienes, and ketones was identified in processed samples of oats. They also show the development of rancidity in processing oats. So basically, oats, by the time they get to the friggin' grocery store, are rancid. And they're moldy, they have mycotoxins all over them, they have rancid fats. This shows the longer the oats are stored, the more rancid they become. So one thing you're probably wondering is just literally like, now I'm confused, what do I eat? All these foods that you're talking about here on this channel, Chris, have all these terrible things in them that go against the true definition of health. So that's why I went and I put together a framework based on achieving these two goals. I want you to be able to correct your micronutrient deficiencies, and I want you to be able to bring your body into a state of hormonal balance. When you do those two things, you're going to be truly healthy. You're going to feel amazing. You're going to have a ton of energy. You're not going to have any libido and sex drive issues. You're going to have very high, good levels of reproductive hormones and thyroid hormones, a high metabolism. You're going to have low stress hormones and low risk for cancers and diseases like that. So what I did was I made a framework. I put together a tool. It's at thethermodiet.com/quiz. And it's where if you answer just a couple quick questions, it takes about 60 seconds. I'm going to be able to identify which organ, there are three key organs in the body, which organ you need to actually optimize and heal to bring your body back into the state of balance. Now, these three key organs in the body are actually the liver, the thyroid, and the pituitary. And what you're going to do is, based on the answers to your questions, I'm going to be able to identify, oh, your liver has some problems and it needs some work. So what we're going to do is put you on a road to correcting that with this framework of diet and nutrition. And this doesn't require you to be, vegan or keto or any of these like dietary identities. It's more above that. It's an agnostic type of thing based on the actual healing and the health of your body, not necessarily based on, fighting about diets and that sort of stuff, which a lot of people do. So go to thethermodiet.com/quiz. Take this quiz, answer a few questions. I'm going to put you on the path toward great health. So thanks for watching the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you on the next video. Rancid toxins and mineral chelators that are going to strip your body of the essential vitamins and minerals that it needs, then you may want to consider taking nuts out of your diet.